Today, there are 2 million descendants of French-Canadian immigrants living in New England. These are our stories. Welcome to the French-Canadian Legacy Podcast.
Venez tous jeunes filles et garçons, je vais vous raconter l'histoire de notre immigration ici aux USA, de grands aventuriers des pays étrangers.
Bonjour everyone, this is Melody with French-Canadian News here on the podcast. We'll start with an article from France Amérique titled Anthony Smith, the general who championed French-American military cooperation. This is the story of American General Anthony Smith, who passed away on May 31, 2020. Smith had an essential role in the military relations between France and the United States. He also directed the French-American Foundation USA for 5 years. Go check out the article to read this amazing story. Next up, we have an article by Juliana LaRue titled Racism and Ethnic Discrimination in Two Articles. In this story, LaRue quotes an article found on Frenchly.com titled What It's Like to Be Black and French in America. This article is by the French Morning Staff and details the current events happening in our country with the Black Lives Matter movement. The story features different perspectives on what it's like having both a black and French background. Both articles will be linked, so do check out the original article on these important discussions. We have a new post by Patrick LaCroix titled Mr. Dubuque Goes to Nashua. In this article, LaCroix features an excerpt from the Boston Daily Globe. Hugo Dubuque, a Franco-American attorney, spoke of the history and experience of French Canadians and Franco-Americans in the United States at a convention in June 1888. Go read up on Franco-American history that I bet you never knew about with Patrick's other blog posts. On the French Canadian Legacy blog, check out the next post from our featured writers telling us why they tell the Franco-American story. This time we have Susan Palin, a writer and performer from Maine, who says, What other story would I tell? The Franco-American story is the one I know, the water I swim in. It is me and I am it. Go read the post on our blog to find out more about Susan and her Franco-American story. Next up, I have an entertaining list for you. The best podcast for Francophiles. Do you want to learn more about French culture, but like me, you don't speak fluent French? No problem at all, because the podcasts on this list are in English. The list features 5 different podcasts with topics from French fashion to culture to history. So go find your new favorite podcast. Moving on to our podcast segment, the North American Francophone podcast has 2 new episodes since the last news segment. The latest episode features Jonathan Olivier, the founder of Les Portagers d'Acadiana, a sustainable farm in Arnaudville, Louisiana that does services in French. The previous episode continues the Franco-American Voices series. Host Claire-Marie Bresson speaks with Franco-Marylander poet Michel, the author of The Sound of French in Baltimore. So go get caught up on the most recent episode and check out any previous ones you may have missed. Before I mention the couple of events I have for you today, I have exciting event-related news. The American Canadian Genealogical Society in Manchester, New Hampshire will be reopening soon. On June 12th, they announced on their site that the governor of New Hampshire has released libraries in the state of New Hampshire to be able to reopen any time after June 15th. We are in the process of developing our reopening guidelines and training our staff to be sure everyone that visits the ACGS library is safe. Please stay tuned to the website and emails to announce our new processes for visiting the library. We are looking forward to seeing everyone in the library again and doing genealogy. And now on to the 2 virtual events that I have for you today. On June 25th from 3 p.m. to 4:30 p.m., the Franco-American Center in Manchester, New Hampshire will be having an event called Franco Foods, Food Conversation and Recipe Swap. This month, it's all about fresh berries, so get ready to talk about your favorite ways to use berries in recipes, and be sure to share your techniques. You must register for this event on the FAC website by June 24th at 12 p.m. This event will be spoken in English and some French. On to our second event, from now until July 9th, the French Cultural Center in Boston is hosting Bastille Day contests. All you have to do is send in a photo of you wearing your most French clothing and accessories. Email your entry to concours@frenchculturalcenter.org. That's C-O-N-C-O-U-R-S at frenchculturalcenter.org. Include your first and last name and your email address. The winners will be announced on July 14th during the French Cultural Center's live Bastille Day event. So get your best French look ready and celebrate. That's all I've got for you this time. Now that summer is officially here, remember to stay safe outdoors and wear plenty of sunscreen. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, Melody. Next week's guest is Renee McMaster, owner of the Hot Mess Poutine food truck. Jesse and Renee will talk about how she moved from Quebec to New Hampshire and why she started a poutine food truck. Just a note that this episode was recorded last year before the COVID-19 pandemic. You can follow them on Facebook for a complete update of where they'll be each week.
All right, cool. So now we got a bonus question. if you don't mind. Because the way okay. we do things here.
I always like those bonus questions.
All right, so you're familiar with the bonus question. All right, so I'm trying to come up with some kind of crazy thing. So, now, are you a sports fan by any chance?
Mm-mm. Yep.
You are a sports fan. All right, so you got to be honest with us. What do you actually think of the Boston Bruins then?
The best.
I can't go over well when you're back at home.
Yeah, they're the best. I mean, I always, always love them.
Even from Quebec.
Yeah, but you know, the time I was in Quebec, at that time we had the Quebec team that was in
the Nordiques. Yeah.
I was a huge fan.
Sure. Okay.
I had my jersey, I had my jacket, everything. And then boom, they were gone, and I never liked the Canadian. Never. So that was all the time the competition.
Right.
Quebec and Montreal and. And so I never liked them. So for me, when I moved to New England, hey, and you know what? Bergeron, you know where he's come from, right?
Quebec City guy. Yeah. Absolutely.
Well, this Marchand, is awesome. Marchand, Bergeron. So, yes. Yeah, I love them.
Well, actually,
I was at the game last year. I was in the first row.
You went to, that's awesome.
Yeah. We had a good time.
You did.
Yes.
Well, I appreciate very much you coming on. This has been a blast.
Now our fathers look at us and sigh with despair to think that everything they love we simply do not share. But the spirit never dies, so our culture will survive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive.
Special thanks to Josie Vachon for providing the music. You can find more about her at josievachon.com. This podcast was produced and edited by Mike Campbell. If you have any questions or comments, please email us at fclpodcast@gmail.com. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at fclpodcast for more information about the topics discussed. If you enjoyed the show, please subscribe and leave us a review on iTunes or wherever you listen to this episode.